We're just trying to make a tune for y'all. Make it nice. We've been to Philadelphia kind of a lot. We've been out of places. And thank you all so much for your hospitality and kindness, for real. I'm going to take on this mic, and then we're going to do some more songs.
We'll be right back. so much. This is fun, man.
All day I thought it was going to be a little chilly, but it is not. Right, it could be warm at the church. You just walk in and sweating out toxins. So there's this crossroads we're at. We talk about trauma, talk about gender, talk about sexual harassment. A lot of the lessons and ideas of feminism have morphed its way into this counterculture and transformed us with Riot Girl years and years ago. This is about accountability, this is about self-defense, this is about looking at yourself and calling yourself on your own shit. That's it for boys. This is about what to do when you feel fucking powerless and there's all this overwhelming nonsense that is extremely dangerous. There is this speech that is violence, and there's violence that is violence. To all of our sisters and mothers and daughters, and to all of us. Sometimes takes place in shape in the form of statues, and loss. This is about when all that shit fades away, it's just people who are left. Minds that are left. Communities and families that are left.
Let's go!
that's coming. I'm not yet. Mr. Shelby might be a little more center in the center. Okay, so we're all getting older. No doubt. Some of you guys saw us at the church. Our relationship is like 15 or 20 years old. And we can't really express how much it means. How much of a happy accident this whole thing with Philadelphia, how much it means to us. But in the course of this punk rock thing, this counterculture that you might keep hidden from your office job, still have a hard time explaining this passion to your families. Maybe by now they figured it out. Just because of sheer stamina. But as this happens, we lose people. We lose friends, and sometimes it's shocking. So this time about what we do with grief, loss. What we do with the people that you know that should be here tonight aren't. So let's finish out the Iron Sheik, Alfred Lloyd. This is for our friend Mark Maitland, who passed away suddenly 2 weeks ago. And this is also just about everyone who needs a space to grieve and be understood and be face to face with each other. Not just liking shit with all the best intentions on Facebook and Instagram, but being right here and right now and just letting go if you have to. It's my first will and testament.
Thank you.
was, none of them are going to be antidote, because I'll do this. I bet it's time to relearn, but we appreciate the shout out. I'll do that. No. I don't think we're going to put it down live. But I'm charmed and flattered that you know that song exists. It's this song we play a lot, actually. And it's one of those songs where you feel like, fucking, we wrote this about media consolidation and distortions of fact and how democracy tends to happen sometimes first through journalism and reporting, and how in like 6 or 7 short years it becomes so fucking twisted and everything we read is just starting to play us against each other. It's just starting to play us against our own reasoning and our own empathy. So it's about seeing through all the black and white and the screens and seeing it infrared. We'll be right back. this place for having us. Enjoying this thing.
This place is fucking great. Thank you guys so much.
We'll be right back.
all of you. Thank you so much. Don't give up hope. Don't feel isolated. You are not fucking alone. You should all just send a letter to each other on a random stranger just to say that. I love you. You are not.